Because there is a policy of the American government, it's called the Kissinger Report, which was produced in the mid-70s when Henry Kissinger was the was involved with the government. And it explicitly states, which to this day, it remains the official policy of the American government. It has not changed. May not be implemented by Trump, but it remains the same. That the purpose of the foreign policy in Africa was to reduce the population. So to give aid to countries in Africa, not clean water and schooling and things like that, but contraception and abortion, in order to shrink the population of Africa because they have great mineral resources there.
That sounds diabolical. I
It
mean,
is, yes.
that sounds like something conceived in the mind of Margaret Sanger.
Definitely. And so the at the time, Kissinger and those involved with the Carter administration wanted to shrink the population, make sure that the Africans do not develop and do not use the resources for themselves, because we in the States, we need them. There is a concerted effort of foreign powers to control the population of Africa. Africa is a huge continent, could feed thousands of more people, but the policies of the West, especially in Europe. For example, between 1990 and the year 2000, the United States, Canada, and Europe contributed about $6 billion in contraceptives, not to help the people, not to give clean water, clean food. That is
Not to fight
not.
malaria, for
Now, of
example.
course, perish the thought, never let them die. That's the whole idea. So, in our work in HLI, we denounce this reality to make the Africans aware that they have to defend themselves against the influence of foreign powers.
Is it just the United States, or do you believe that China is also playing a role in jockeying for the resources of Africa?
China is playing a major role because China is buying property in Africa. For example, in Mozambique, which is a Portuguese speaking language country, when Portugal was in charge of Mozambique, they used to export rice. Now they are importing rice from China because they cannot produce. The socialism has wrecked the production of rice. And the Chinese come and buy farms. So about almost a third of Mozambique belongs to China. So I was in other countries of Africa, the same reality. In South
Scary.
Africa, the Chinese are buying property, buying land in Africa.
So
And they send their own workers, the Chinese workers. They don't employ people over the place. They have sent their own workers to populate and to live in the place.